Revelation 13, we're going to read a little bit about the Antichrist here. Revelation 13, verse number 3, the Bible says, "And I saw one of his heads, as it were, wounded to death, and his deadly wound was healed, and all the world wondered after the beast." I think that this is referring to an actual event that's going to happen where the Antichrist receives literally like a wound to his head. Now, again, when you're reading Revelation 13, you're going to read about various heads, and there's heads of a beast, and they have different meanings, and you know, and the horns and everything else. But when we get to this point, and it's talking about this deadly wound that's healed, and all the world's going to wonder at this, I don't think this is just talking about some reference to like the Ottoman Empire or some kingdom, some nation that has been destroyed in the past and now is all of a sudden going to resurface that everyone's going to wonder at. I think this is talking about another example of the devil trying to duplicate or mimic Jesus Christ, right, or through the Antichrist, receiving a deadly wound, just like Jesus was crucified and died on the cross, and then 3 days later he rose again from the dead. I believe this is Satan, you know, through the Antichrist performing that same type of event where he's going to die and then somehow be brought back to life. And everyone's going to wonder at that. Everyone's going to see that and be like, wow, how could that happen? And be amazed by that. And that might be the very moment. I mean, the devil might actually take over, you know, and again, that's, I'm not dogmatic about that belief, but that's where I think might actually happen, is that he kind of possesses then that vessel, because, you know, the Antichrist being an actual person, you know, when someone dies, they're dead. I don't believe that the devil has power to bring back life. However, he's going to at least stage that event to make it look like, or, you know, where someone's coming back from death. His deadly wound is healed. He's going to come back to life, and all people are going to see that. And it's going to be another one of those lying wonders and miracles that deceives almost everybody. And it's going to be so powerful, the Bible says, that if it were possible, it would deceive the very elect. I mean, those of us that are saved, we'd look at that and go, wow, I have no explanation for that. That must be God, except we won't be deceived. Because we have the Spirit, we have the Holy Ghost residing inside of us that's going to help us discern truth from fiction. It's going to help us understand, no, wait a minute, something's going to be blaring at us going, this is fake, this is the Antichrist, this is not Jesus Christ. I mean, we have enough written in Scripture to tell us that, of what to expect next, of who to expect to come, that we know the Antichrist is going to come, and Jesus Christ himself said, you know, when they tell you, lo, Christ is here, or lo, he's there, believe him not. Like, don't believe him. It doesn't matter what signs and wonders and everything else that they're doing. Jesus already told us that these wonders are going to happen. Don't be deceived by it. He's saying, because when the Son of Man comes, he says, the lightning shines from the east and goes all the way to the west. He says, so is the coming of the Son of Man. Every eye is going to see him. There's going to be no mistake in this. When Jesus Christ comes back, it's undoubtable. It's just, yep, there's Jesus Christ. Everyone will know about it. It will be a sure thing. It's not a, well, there's someone over here doing, you know, these miracles and this stuff. Nope, that's not the return of Jesus Christ. So we don't need to be deceived by that. So he has a deadly wound that's healed. Revelation 13, let's keep reading here. Verse number 4, the Bible says, and they worshiped the dragon, which gave power unto the beast. And they worshiped the beast, saying, who is like unto the beast? Who is able to make war with him? So again, you know, this concept that the beast might be some other nation or something like that is saying, who's going to make war with him? It's a person. Who's going to make war with him? Why? Because the beast received a wound unto death and is now alive again. Well, how do you kill somebody? How do you win a war against someone that if they die, they're just going to come right back up, right back to life? Right? I mean, it's just kind of like, who's going to fight against this? And they're already worshiping the dragon, they're worshiping the devil, and they're worshiping the Antichrist.